Welcome. Welcome to the Fantastic Horror Film Awards. Yay. Who we just saw on stage, they are very humble, but I am going to start by saying that Mike and Joanne are the reason this festival exists. They are fantastic human beings who absolutely love this genre with all their hearts. They are fans first and foremost who created this festival to celebrate us. So I just want to really raise our glasses to those two lovely folks here. Mike and Joanne, come up here a second. They didn't even say anything about themselves. I'm proud to know them and so happy that they are holding this festival for all of us. So Mike and Joanne, cheers to these two lovely people.
Before we get things started, I would like to find out if Josh Baxter is in the room. You know how there's always somebody behind the scenes to help you out that you never expected, right? Josh was here the day we got started. He set up our step and repeat. He took it over to the theater. He did everything wonderfully for us, and I would like to give him this award. A very special thank you, Josh Baxter, General Manager of McFadden San Diego.
If we can have a moment of silence, this is for Erwin Keyes, a very human being. The week in February 1981, before Erwin Keyes was seen in his first major American television performance as George Jefferson's bodyguard Hugo in The Jeffersons. Anybody remember that?
Yeah!
The 29-year-old aspiring character actor told San Francisco Examiner feature writer Jeannie Miller, "I tried to be average and fail, so I became an actor." Yeah. His full life story and storied professional career of Erwin Keyes is a much more elaborate and heroic odyssey than that of a very wry and charming summary implies. For his closest friends and members of Erwin Keyes' family, one of the things we love have been has been consistently inspired by is how steadfastly our dear brother has pursued his dream while remaining positive against tremendous odds and challenges with a whole lot of hard work and a wonderful sense of humor. The hulking 6-foot, 250-pound actor, and he was big, remained remarkably upbeat through his life, although he was consistently typecast as a heavy, even grisly roles. Erwin even joked in an interview, "I cornered the market on Brutes. I played a rotten, sadomasochistic cop in The Warriors, a ghetto ghoul in The Exterminator, a Transylvanian swinger in Nocturna." I haven't seen that one. I want to see that one. "And a gangster in The Prize Fighter." Erwin continued to fight tirelessly and fearlessly on films, television, and commercials for the next 30 years, gaining international recognition for his portrayals of the malicious henchman Dweezy Joe in a 2003 Coen film, Intolerable Cruelty, and as Fred and Barney's friend Joe Rockhead in The Flintstones, 1994. Yeah. And the wild mess man Ravelli in Rob Zombie's House of a Thousand Corpses.
Yes.
Erwin often told us personally, "You know, above all, you gotta learn to tell a good and compelling story no matter what genre of art you're creating in. And any artist worthy of that name is always learning." Now raise your glasses. "When we never stop learning from the humility, humanity, and tender loving heart of Erwin Keyes," and it's written by Todd Barkin and Eileen Blake, the sister of Erwin Keyes.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
And so in this year, we actually are giving away 3 awards on this. The nominees are Susan Morton for Auto Corrected, Melanie Dunstrunger for Canyon Club, Alexander Surowitz for Encounter, Haberfelder, he's in Austria, he doesn't know what's going on yet. It's called Frank and Sharkinator. which it was rather unusual. And Gregory Blair for Garden Party. Cliff Goldsmith for Mangled Angels. The second runner-up for this award is Canyon Club Melanie Grunder, and she is not here. The first runner-up is Encounter, and I don't think Alexander Surwitz is here. But I do know that Gregory Blair is here. And Gregory Blair is our number one winner for this award.
Wow. Thanks to Mike and Joanne for making all of this happen.
Party bell. It's like the garden party. It's like the garden party massacre is happening right here at table one.
Oops, I didn't do that. we actually have just finished production, and so the film will hopefully be out next year. So this is a good start. Thank you.
And he's going to be submitting it to next year's festival. You all know that, right?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yay.
Bye.
Okay, so best original story and script. We have the nominees, Bum with a Gun. We have Cut. We have Kokeshi, I hope I said that right. Model Hunger. And last but not least, Once When I Was Dead. Oh, I have to open this. Okay.
We don't want to make it too easy.
Don't make it easy. Oh, the suspense. Ah, amazing. And the winner is Cut. Come on up and receive your award.
Wow. Thank you, guys.
That's heavy.
It is heavy. This is amazing. Wow. Thank you, guys, very much. I appreciate it. I'm David Roundtree, by the way. Thank you. The script, the original story was co-written by David Banks, who's also the lead actor in Cut, who does a phenomenal job. And we really spent quite a bit of time kind of crafting this. And it's a satire of the independent filmmaking world. So if you have anything to do with filmmaking, you probably will enjoy some of this movie. So we really appreciate it. It's a lot of people came to make this happen. And the story that we put on paper was really given life by our audio more than anything. Our post-audio team, the sound design, Christina Horgan is in the back, is just fantastic, because without that music coming together, our story could never be told with what we hoped and what we penned in the story itself. The life that was given by our sounds and by our audio, it blew me away and took it to a level I never saw it even coming. So. With that being said, I really appreciate this. So many people helped make this movie, and we're really happy. And Matt Chasen, thank you for helping with our movie, getting it out there, getting the word. And if you get a chance to see it, it's on a lot of distribution outlets right now. iTunes, it's on Netflix DVD, it's on Hulu right now. It just released Hulu. You can watch it for free on Hulu, so check it out. But thank you guys very much. This is fantastic.
Let's give it up one more time for Cut!
Here are the nominees for Best Cinematography. We have Vacation Trip at a Treacherous Hotel, Model Hunger, Schizophrenia, Strangers in the Book, and Thicker Than Water. And the winner is... Auto Hunger.
We have the star Lynn Lowry to accept the award.
I know Wolfgang Meyer would really love this, since he's the cinematographer on it. So I will definitely maybe give it to him. and thank you so much.
So this is Best Comedy, Grim Thing Coming, Bullets, Fangs, and Dinner Yay! With Apes. Chomp. And Crippleton, Talk to the Hands. And Spammer. And the winner is... I've never done this before. Hans Crippleton, Talk to the Hands.
So I'm Krista Silver. The majority of Hans was shot at the ranch where I work at. And, well, I did all kinds of stuff down there. I was Southern Belle. My husband was Clyde. Jimmy Lee and Kevin are going to be so excited. This is heavy. I really think this is heavy. It's going to add to my luggage weight, guys. Thank you. We're going to love this. Thank you so much.
So for best fantasy horror, A Grim Becoming, Kokeshi, Seeking Valentina, Schizophrenia, Strangers in a Book. Suspense music. And the award goes to Schizophrenia.
Let's see here. Scariest death scene, our wonderful, scary, deathly nominees. Bum with a Gun. Model Hunger. Once When I Was Dead. The Peripheral and The Scarehouse. I know there was blood, I know there was chains, I know there was all sorts of instruments of torture. Let's see who scared the crap out of those guys the most. Now Mike, your private line. And the winner is The Peripheral! Come on up, Peripheral!
Hi.
Hi.
I died first. We don't know who it was.
Or what it was.
But we both died. So thanks. Here we go, the Goriest Film Award. And we have... Bum with a Gun. Right. We have Cut. We have Kokeshi. We have, once again, Model Hunger. And lastly, we have Once When I Was Dead. Exciting. It's glued in there, I'm sorry, it's not coming out. Okay, fantastic, no, that's the title. Fantastic Horror Film Festival. The winner is Model Hunger.
Here's the lovely Lynn from Model Hunger.
We had a pig in it, and we cut it up, and it was kind of bloody, and I guess I did some gory stuff. So.
Yes, you did!
But I won't go into that, so thank you.
So, Scariest Killer, the nominees are Bum with a Gun, Model Hunger, The Peripheral, The Scarehouse, and Sickle. the winner is The Peripheral.
Hi. We didn't kill anyone, but we both died. The killer was this great creature actually created by Ron Cole. It was stop motion animation, which was a big deal because nobody does that anymore. And it looked really cool and scary and weird. And we didn't know what it looked like while we were filming. So we didn't know who the killer was.
Jurassic World.
Right, they didn't know. But they probably knew what a dinosaur looked like. But we didn't know what the killer was. But yeah.
Thank you.
So best of couple. All Bavarian and Kristen West, Seeking Valentina. Kathy Mayer and Lynn Lowry, The Beauty Becoming. Anya Cherry and Vita Jafari, Seeking Valentina. Gilbert Jr. and Melantha Blackhorn, A Grim Becoming. And David Roundtree and Dahlia Salem, Cut. Bill Overs Jr. and Melantha Blackhorn, The Grim Becoming.
I will accept this award on behalf of Melantha Blackhorn, who is the only woman I've been allowed to be intimate with on screen without killing her first or killing her afterwards. She's alive, and that was nice. Melantha will, I think, change the way that people think of peanut butter after seeing this scene. So I accept it on her behalf with thanks to the Fantastic Horror Film Festival.
Well, me and Bill kind of made it up as we went along on that shot, so I'm very grateful for Melantha and Blackthorn and Bill Overs to come together with me and create that scene. So that's really all I got to say. So thank you very much.
And this is Best Line. And, okay, we got nominees are, or he could be ordering a double bacon cheeseburger from A Grim Becoming.
These lines. Say that again, please.
Okay, one more time. How's that? Okay, or he could be ordering a double bacon cheeseburger from A Grim Becoming. Okay, all right. And the next one's I Am Not a Zombie from Chomp.
To read this one. I'm just totally stealing the mic like a total actress right now. Any idiot with a digital camera can call themselves a filmmaker. From Cut.
That's a good one.
All right, and the next one is, not so perky are you now, bitch. From Model Hunger. And last one, I'll always be there when you need me. Seeking Valentina. Aww. And if I could open this up. All right, who glued it? You welded it?
It's the suspense. You're building the suspense.
Suspense. Ooh, I like this movie myself. I got the chance to see it. Any idiot with a digital camera can call himself. Yeah! Cut.
So Seuss cannot be here tonight. I am 100% honored to accept this on her behalf. And I'm so honored because in the storyline in Cut, Seuss Lanier Bromlett from Hills Have Eyes, which is one of the greatest independent horror movies ever, which inspired movies like What We Do. Seuss came in and she played herself in the movie. And in the story, she plays a director who is directing her own movie, and she makes fun of today's generation because it's somewhat true. Any idiot with a digital camera these days calls themselves a filmmaker, and it takes so much work to do something. And having Seuss, who was one of my role models growing up, it was one of the first horror movies I ever saw, to actually have her in the movie, and to get to work with her and direct her in a scene, have her deliver a line like that was amazing. So this is for Sue's accepting it for her, for The Hills Have Eyes, for independent horror, making what we're able to do here today. So thank you guys very much. Sue's Lanier Bromlett, you are awesome. I wish you were here, but this is for you.
Short film, Counterparts, Killers. What is that? Kokeshi?
Yes, ma'am.
Once When I Was Dead. Stammer.
Oh, nice.
Oh, cool.
Thank you, guys.
Once When I Was Dead.
Hi, I'm Scott Perry, the director of Once When I Was Dead. The special effects here was done by a fantastic 23-year-old artist named Lisa Forst, who I worked with on several projects, and when we did one, she did an absolutely amazing job working on it. So on behalf of her, I'm really happy that she won it. She really busted her butt doing it. And she is a terrific artist who has a bright future ahead of her. So on behalf, as I said, thank you for acknowledging me.
Original score in a short film. He Waits. Once When I Was Dead. The Peripheral again. Seeking Valentina again. And Sweetheart. And the winner is Seeking Valentina.
Seeking Valentina, congratulations.
Thank you, everybody. Wow. I am like ecstatic right now. Really?
There you go.
Thank you, first and foremost, Mike, and is it Janine?
Joanne.
I'm sorry. Thank you for giving us this opportunity to be able to express ourselves. It means a lot to me. Thank you. Thank you, Armin. Thank you, Matt. Thank you, Christian. We worked very hard on this. This is my first swing at scoring a film, and we did the best that we could do. I'm glad you guys liked what I did. Thank you.
Okay. Design in a short film. God Sins. Kokeshi. Seeking Valentina. Spammer. Strangers in a Book. There's all kinds of surprises in these angles.
That would be the winner. She's building a lot of suspense, guys.
And the winner is Seeking Valentina.
Thank you very much. I want to thank Mike and Joanne Thomas and Fantastic Horror Film Festival. I want to thank Matt Chasen, Kristen West. I'm very happy that Sky Cross and Vita Gafari were able to make it to San Diego. It means so much. And thank you so much. I didn't realize how much all that door knocking and really affected people. Thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Kenny. I'm one of the co-directors of Sweetheart, and I'll be presenting Best Editing of a Short Film. And the nominees are Once When I Was Dead, The Peripheral, Seeking Valentina, Schizophrenia, and Spammer.
Thank you.
Once When I Was Dead.
I co-edited this with a really good friend of mine, Stolas Hadjiharlambis, and he's such a fantastic editor, and I was becoming a little too close with it, and you know, when you direct something and you edit it, you come too close, and I needed some help in doing it, and I think without Stolas' help and guidance doing it, it wouldn't be the film that it is today, so I'm accepting it on behalf of mainly him, even though we're co-credited, because he is really an amazing editor, and I can't thank you guys enough for it. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Cody Lepke. I'm the co-director and the writer and the star of Sweetheart, thank you, I forgot my movie. And I'm here to for Best Supporting Actress in a Short Film. I'm going to mispronounce these, so I'm very sorry. Vida Gafriera, Seeking Valentina. John Mack, Strangers in a Book. Cephas, Once When I Was Dead. Kristen West, Strangers in a Book. Kaylee Williams, Once When I Was Dead. It was already pre-open for me. Kaylee Williams, Once When I Was Dead.
Kaylee, she did a great job in this. Again, was willing to go in and have cold blood splattered all over her, like there's so many others that you have been as well. And she laid it on the line to get this story, and she did a really great job. And I'm very happy to have been able to work with her. So, thank you.
Okay, so we have Best Supporting Actor in a Short Film. I hope I don't mess up the names here. Marv?
Lavelle.
Yes.
You got it.
For Strangers in a Book? Cody Lupke for Sweetheart?
I don't know
this one either. Srinivasa? It's a beautiful name, but... Yes! For Seeking Valentina. We have Armin Nasseri for Seeking Valentina. And Joel Wynkoop for Chomp. And the winner is... Cody Lepke for Sweetheart.
I'm actually really shocked and surprised, and thank you guys very much. I don't have a speech prepared, but you know, this is a movie we almost didn't make. I came up with the idea and we filmed it 2 weeks later, and here we are. Thank you guys so much for that. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
So, okay, Best Actress in a Short Film. I'm gonna probably murder these names and blame it on the beers, so don't blame me. But. We'll go from there. First off, Strangers in a Book. That's
Vida Gafari.
Oh, that's so close. Okay. So that's number one. Lynn Lowry, and that's the Thank you. No, yeah, I'm sorry. Yes, I'm sorry. Silvio Sortino and Kateshi. Gabriel Stone and Once When I Was Dead. And Kristen West in Seeking Valentine. All right. And here comes, drum roll please. Oh, of course, it's Kristen West, Seeking Valentine.
Oh my goodness, this was not expected. Oh my God, thank you. Mike and Joanne, thank you so much for putting on this festival. Armin, thank you for giving me a role. Because she wrote it with a lot of heart. And thank you for allowing me to do it. And thank you, all of you who watched it, who were there at the screening, and everybody who supported us. And Annette, thank you. And I'm so touched, and I want to thank my mom too, because she's in Texas and like staying up and saying text me, and thank you. Thank you all so much. I'm so
do this, and again, I will probably mispronounce everybody's name and the movie. Oh my gosh, okay. I'm gonna do it in my New Jersey accent, so that you won't be so mad at me. Ollie, Bavarian for Seeking Valentina.
Yeah!
Yes! Gregory Blair, he waits. And Randy Frank for the Periphery. Oh my god, I'm so excited. Right? Aren't you? Kyle Porter for Chomp. And Paolo Salvadio. I'm so sorry, I know I mispronounced that. For Kodeshi. Sorry for all the pronunciation. Just call me John Travolta. Okay. And the winner is Ali Bavarian. Hopefully I'm saying that right. For Seeking Valentina.
Thank you. Unfortunately, Ali couldn't make it. He's working on a movie right now, and I am accepting this award on his behalf. I just want to say that it was a pleasure working with Ali Bavarian. Not only is he a very talented actor, but he's also a great guy, and you know, he was such a trooper. I mean, every single take, he put in his 100%. And I was very lucky to have him, and also during the filming, you know, his birthday was occurred during the shooting, and we celebrated his birthday while we were filming. And Ali, if you're out there, if you can hear me, this is your birthday present. Thank you.
I'm up here with my brother Benji Roundtree, who's also an actor. And we will be announcing the best director of a short film.
All right, the first nominee is Micah Delhauer, Black Orchid.
Lynn Hansen, Chomp.
Armin Nazari, Seeking Valentina.
Scott W. Perry, Once When I Was Dead.
And last but not least, J.T. Seaton, The Peripheral.
And the winner of Best Director of a Short Film is
Armin Nazari, Seeking Valentina. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Well, first, I want to thank Mike and Joanne Thomas for selecting a non-bloody, non-violent, non-gory film, Seeking Valentina, into the Fantastic Horror Film Festival. I want to thank Matt Chasen. Not only did he help associate produce this film, but he's been a great friend, a mentor. He's been an instrumental figure throughout the process of this movie. I want to thank Kristen West. She's really been the heart and soul of this movie. Like, this movie, I don't know where what it'll be without her. I mean, she put 110% ever since the beginning. I want to thank Vita Gafare for being here. You know, she's been great to work with. And I want to thank my best friend, Sky Cross. We knew each other since 2005. We started off as actors in Wilmington, North Carolina. And 10 years later, we started working behind the whole post-production process. And I want to thank the cast and crew for following us on this journey. I mean, we went through 3 counties, 6 days, 500 miles. And to all you guys out there, cast and crew, this is what hard work. This is what your hard work looks like. And this Best Director Award only means that, you know, for me, this is only the beginning. And there's a lot more work to be done. Thank you.
And just, I wanted to bring up this guy standing to my left. I don't know if you guys have met him. His name's Joe. He is so instrumental to this festival. I love him dearly. He's a fabulous fan, a fabulous human. He supports a lot of us actors as a promotional publicist for us, if you will. He's constantly speaking up my projects. And I just want to take a moment for us to all thank Joe, who does a lot of work on this festival. Come up, Joe, and say a few words.
Thank you so much, my dear Tiffany. Love you.
We love you.
Love you, love you. And love all of you guys. I know I work with a lot of you in a lot of projects, so Who am I? Well, I'm a producer now in Hollywood, and I shoot a lot of films. So right now I'm working on 5 films, a documentary, and as people that I work with and hire means that I what I do, they keep telling me, Joey, you can do more than that. So I just keep adding titles to my resume. So that is who I am. If you ever need anything from me, you know where to reach me or come up to me, and I'll be more than glad to give you a hand. I love all of you guys, and keep up all the good work that you guys do. Thank you so much.
For the best short film, He Waits. Once When I Was Dead. The Peripheral. Seeking Valentina. Strangers in a Book. Winner is. Once When I Was Dead. I had lunch with this guy today, and I was like, I really hope I get to give this to you today. So, rock on.
Wow. I'm kind of speechless right now. Thank you so much. Thank you to Mike and Joanne for honoring us with this. Thank you, everybody, for liking it and supporting it. You know, Matt, what else can I say? Thank you so much. It's been great. It's been a great 3 days. I mean, for me personally, this is a very difficult film to get. It took me 9.5 years to get it done. And two factors got it made. The first one is the man standing next to me, Tony DiBenedetto, who was the executive producer on it. And the second factor was our lead actress, Gabrielle Stone, who really believed in it. And when she agreed to do it, I was very happy. And it led to so many things. And it's really an honor to be to have this, and I can't thank you guys so much. Thank you, really, and I'm hoping this is the start of many other things. So, all right, thank you so much.
Okay, best original score in a feature film: Bum with a Gun, Cut. I'm accepting the award for our composer for Cut, Mark McDermott. Just kidding. I know. I worked with Mark very closely on the film. I was the sound designer for Cut, and we worked together religiously. And that's really something that is not so common these days. And a lot of times the composer ends up doing the sound design. But we collaborated and back and forth, and we came up with something quite unique. And it was a lot of fun. So on behalf of Mark, thank you very much to Fantastic.
All right, this is for Best Sound in a Feature Film. Bum with a Gun. We have Cut. Ghost Walk the Farm. Portend. And lastly, The Scare House. The winner is Cut.
Thank you so much. Thank you to Fantastic Horror Film Festival. This has just been the best, and I'm very deeply honored. And I really want to thank my director, producer, David Roundtree. David allowed me to really get inside his brain to see his vision, and then he gave me free rein to do what I wanted. And it was the best experience ever. And my kitchen suffered dearly for it for 3 weeks as I recorded every pot and pan in my kitchen and tool for my garage to try and deliver the type of sound that he was looking for cut. And then I had a lot of fun turning it into what you hear in the movie. So thank you, David, from the bottom of my heart. And thank you, Fantastic, and everyone who came to see it. And please, if you haven't, go see it. It's a thinker movie. It's really good.
And the nominations for Best Editing are, in a feature film, A Grim Becoming. Bomb with the Gun. Cut. Model Hunger. And Sickle. And the winner is, I always wanted to do that. Oh my goodness, Lynn Lowry, get up here, Model Hunger!
I just wanted to say that Debbie Rashan had a lot of trouble finishing this film and putting it together. There was just a lot of shit that went on, which I didn't even know when I was filming it, but she, you know, got through it, and she worked for like about, I don't know, 2 years to make it happen, and I know she will be very, very proud of all the wonderful awards she's gotten tonight, so thank you so much.
Best Supporting Actress in a Feature Film.
Oh, cool.
Oh, God.
Okay.
I didn't need that. It was, she was telling me I had a phone call. First up is Melanthea Blackhorn for A Grim Becoming. I have this one. Babette Bombshell for Model Hunger. Yes. Oh. Lynn Lowry, Complete Stranger for A Grim Becoming. I wish I knew who that was. Eva Roca. That's what I was gonna say. Bullets, Fangs, and Dinner at 8. And last but not least, also Debbie Rashan for Model Hunger. Amazing. All right. And the award goes to The Total Stranger, Lynn Lowry for A Grim Becoming.
Wow. Thank you. I want Pat to come up here.
Pat!
Yeah! I gotta tell you when you hold it up.
I will.
When I got to the Grim Becoming to shoot with Adam, that they were putting Pat in like what, 93-year-old makeup. And I said, well, are you gonna make me up? And they said, well, no, you're just gonna do your own makeup. And I thought, well, that's gonna be weird. And so one of the crew members came up to me and said, you know, you could be his granddaughter. And so I thought, well, wow, you know, what about like a, you know, like a trophy wife? And so then Adam and I, you know, we brainstormed and we thought of like, you know, kind of like a Brooklyn sort of airhead kind of, you know, person like that. And so that was how that was created. And so mother and father were together in that movie. And, you know, it was wonderful. So, thank you.
Wow, this is a great award. Let me just move over her. Pat and Lynn, have you ever seen the film, them on screen is like, two peas in a pod, and yes, I did make Pat much older than Lynn, but it was all for a good cause, because And then you pulled it off really well to be that trophy wife, you know what I'm saying? I still remember when Liv came to me, she's like, you want me to be the trophy wife, right? I'm like, yes, I want you to be the trophy wife because you are just stunning and Pat is just old. So we won't be able to tell him, apart, and you guys did an amazing job because you made the film make it possible. So thank you very much. Thank you very much.
And Best Supporting Actor in a Feature Film is Michael Allen Hollinger for Bum with a Gun. Erwin Heath. Chris Muir for Cut. Bill Obers Jr. for A Grim Becoming. And Bill Obers Jr. for The Dooms Chapel Horror. And the winner is Erwin Keyes.
Thank you so much. On behalf of Eileen Glick, who is the brother of Erwin Keyes, let's hear for Eileen Glick. Her sister, his sister, Eileen Glick.
And here's Erwin.
And she's carrying Erwin with him? With her? Okay. But as we said earlier when we accepted the award, that's going to be inaugurated for Erwin Keyes. He was one of the most wonderful human beings that we've ever been blessed with in our lives. Oh, you are worthy. And thank you to everyone at the festival for all your great work and for honoring Erwin in this way. We deeply love you and appreciate you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for your great work. And all of you too. Thank you.
This is for Best Actress in a Feature Film. And the nominees are Sarah Booth for The Scare House. Lynn Lowry for Model Hunger. Kimberly Sue Murray for The Scare House. Dahlia Salem for Cut. And Tiffany Shepis for Model Hunger. And the winner is Lynn Lowry, Model Hunger.
So I really wanted to win for Model Hunger. I'm very, very happy. And I knew that all the work I did on all those schizophrenic, psychotic, Southern Belle, Tennessee Williams characters would finally one day work out. So I'm very happy about that. But I can tell you, you know, I was looking through on Facebook and I saw that Debbie Rashan, who had was on the cover of Fangoria, and I PM'd her and congratulated her and told her, you know, that I'd love to work with her. And she sent me immediately the Model Hunger script. And I, you know, there was one scene in it that I was a little bit reluctant, you know, so I am kind of surprised that I did win a Best Actress Award for literally eating pussy, but. I did say that, I did. Like clams, you know. Anyway, I want to thank Joe, Quintanilla, for, you know, all of his support. So fabulous. I want to thank Matt Chasen, my manager. Just, you know, fabulous. And of course, Debbie Rashan and James Morgart, who wrote the script and created the character. And all the cast and crew were just, it's like one of my favorite films that I've ever done. It's just, it is so fucking good to play someone so fucking bad. Thank you.
Okay, the Best Actor in a Feature Film, we have David Banks from Cut. Woo! Austin Manning, The Dooms Chapel Horror. David Roundtree, Cut. Michael Shavarasi, A Grim Becoming. Wow, lots of friends here. Kevin award, Hans Crippleton Thompson Hans. And the winner is.
Come on, people, make the music. Come on, let's roll.
Okay, and the winner is Michael Shabarossi.
Sorry, I'm not Mike Shabarossi. My name is Mark Mendola, and I am one of the producers and assistant directors on Grim and Cumming. This is Adam Steigerman, as you all know. And on behalf of Mike Shabarossi, I'd like to accept this award. He did a fantastic job. Congratulations to him.
Oh, yes, today is his birthday. Happy birthday to Michael. He does deserve this award. He did an amazing job, and he played it very Shakespearean. And I don't know anybody else that could have done the job that he did. So I'm very proud of him. So good job to Mike.
Great job. Okay, so best director of feature film, Adam Steiger for Grim Becoming. Gavin Michael Booth for The Scarehouse. Matthew Rocha, Bullets, Fangs, and Dinner at Eight. Debbie Rochon for Model Hunger. And David Roundtree for Cut. The winner is David Roundtree for Cut.
Wow. Oh, thank you. Okay, thank you very much. Wow, this is really kind of amazing. I'd like to thank, you know, Mike and Joanne, of course, for just even putting this on and recognizing independent filmmaking and allowing us to have a platform to show our movies and get it out there. And it's unbelievable because there aren't too many platforms to show what we do. And usually in this independent world, we make something which is the hopes that someone will see it. And to actually do something and get in front of an audience has been a tremendous opportunity and a blessing, and I'm so happy to be standing here. And you know, Cut was definitely a labor of love from start to finish, and there were so many people that went into this to make it happen. Of course, my family, my wife back there, Rosie, my daughter Chloe, and mother-in-law Maria, who put up with the many late nights, me coming in at 5 a.m. and, you know, banging around and waking them up and all kinds of stuff. And of course, the team that just put all this together, you know, I'm so happy Chris won for sound design, because the work she put in just made this and helped bring my vision. And what I tried to capture on film was nowhere near the end product compared to what all the other hands that went into it, you know, to tell my story was just phenomenal. So this has been a wonderful, wonderful thing. I'm so happy my brother Benji's here with us tonight. To get him here. He just moved out here from Florida not too long ago, now lives in San Diego, so this is a wonderful time to have the festival here, and I'm just so happy. I'm really honored, and this is wonderful. And everybody, keep making films, keep supporting each other, do what we can, because without us, you know, no one knows about us. You know, without what we do, without, you know, supporting each other and getting the word out about each and one of these films. Thank you, Chloe.
Ladies and gentlemen, the nominees for Best Feature Film are A Grim Becoming, yeah! Bum with a Gun, oh my God. Model Hunger, yeah! The Scare House. Thank you, Envelope Girl. And the winner is... Oh, these are the...
Oh, no!
I want a new Envelope Girl. Thank you very much. I deserve that. The winner is Model Hunger.
Man, I'm not prepared. I am not a great spontaneous speaker here, and I had no idea I was going to win so many awards, or I would have worked all these speeches out. So it was a great role for me. I love doing it. Love showing, you know, what it's like to be rejected and thrown to the side when you get older, which is what the movie is about. And of course, you know, Debbie, Rashawn, and James Margart wrote all that, so they cast me to show you that and make you feel that, so thank you.
This
share, our number one fan is one of our volunteers, and her name is Alexandria Tsai. But we also have an honorable mention, Joy and Karina, if you would please come up. You have been fabulous and helpful and done wonderful things. We love our volunteers.
Welcome you here to the fantastic Horror Film Festival Red Carpet. I have with me the man who won the most awards, gotta be the most awards. I'll hedge my bets. Some of the most awards, highest award-winning film, but I think it really is the highest award-winning film. Cut. Okay, David, show me what you got. Show the camera. Let's see what you got.
Hi, it's upside down.
Okay, we've got the first one is Best Director, David Roundtree, right here on my left. And then we have Best Original Story Script, and we have Best Original Score in a Feature Film, and one more time, Best Line. Bring me that Best Line with all you got.
The Best Line was great. It was delivered by Suze Lanier Bromlett from the original Hills Have Eyes. And it's, any idiot with a digital camera can call themselves a filmmaker. So maybe that's how I won these awards. I don't know.
Okay. I imagine that everybody here's heard that more
maybe.
Than once.
We also won Best Sound Design by Christina Horgan. She has her trophy. And that's probably the one I'm most proud of because she spent so much time making this come to life. And without the sound, in any kind of horror film, the movie doesn't live. It doesn't exist. And what she added to that made this movie breathe and come to life and gave it the spirit that it has.
Okay, you heard it from David Roundtree, director of Cut, the most awarded horror film here at Fantastic Horror Film Festival, and we'll see you on the red carpet.
See you guys on the red carpet. Thank you.
Horror film fans, we're here on the Fantastic Horror Film Festival red carpet. After the awards ceremony, we're talking to
Vita Ghaffari.
No. The beautiful and talented Vita Ghaffari. Come on.
Thank you.
Now, how many films were you in this festival?
I was in three films. I was in Strangers in a Book, Seeking Valentina, and Natural Born Filmmakers.
Okay, here's the hard question. Which one did you like better?
I loved all of them in their own way.
Oh, that's a politician's answer, not an actor's answer.
I come from a very political family. You know, I love Seeking Valentina for the ethereal qualities of the film. Kristen was in a very whimsical role. Armin is a very dedicated director. It was great working with him. Ali Bavarian was wonderful. The whole cast was great. Everyone was sounding. It was very interesting for me because it was my first lead dramatic role. I'm really a comedy person at heart. And I've done a lot of sketching improv in my career. So that was tremendous being in a drama with again, lovely Kristen West, with Christina Gittes-Gibble from Little Women LA, with right. John Mack from Saw 6, and Carl Breslin from The Usual Suspects, who was the voiceover role. It was just great bunch of people. Pedro Navon is a very talented name it, doctor, lawyer, male model, published author. He just got nominated for the Pushcart Prize. He wrote the script in a couple hours. So that was tremendous. And Mark Resvani was our director, and David S. Barron, shout out, was our wonderful cinematographer. Everything was wonderful. That Natural Born Filmmakers was very interesting because it was a wonderful ensemble. I worked with many friends, like the wonderful Gregory Blair, who won tonight. Way to go, Gregory. The lovely Donna Lee Heising, who's also a great friend. There was a great cast from that one. And we had a loss with I was, you know, just beginning to get to know her, and then she passed. So that was rough. So this is very bittersweet. Shout out to big shout out to Joanne and Mike Thomas for all the amazing. It was truly a pleasure.
Well, there you have it from the talented and beautiful at the Fantastic Horror Film Festival red carpet. Horror film fans, we're here on the Fantastic Horror Film Festival red carpet after the award ceremony. I have with me here the fellow vampire. Oh, see, he does that even so much better than I can. I'll have to be my own rule next time. Okay, and this is the Best of the Fest Award. And what exactly is the Best of the Fest Award?
The Best of the Fest Award is the award
that I didn't actually know was even an award until today. It was a complete surprise, really humbling, great experience. They announced that the Best of Fest was basically what had the most impact, according to the judges. They were able to see how the audience reacted, and I guess the Bullets fans had a really strong reaction from the audience, and the judges were able to take that and put that into this very special award. This award is not determined by the fan vote, because it needed to be from the data for them to actually see the audience interacting and see how they react. So to me, that was just a wonderful thing, because it's the audience that, you know, the fans and the audience that directors and filmmakers really look for.
It feels amazing.
I got to see firsthand audience, friends, supporters, you know, their reactions to things, them laughing at things that were really funny, and then suddenly something really violent, horrible would happen, and they would just get silent. And so it was the best experience for me to just be able to see that reaction from them, and then the fact that the wonderful judges here were able to see that too, is really nice.
The Town and Matthew Rocca Award winning here, the Best of the Fest Award. Oh, and Vampire. Hello, horror fans. Here we are on the Fantastic Horror Film Festival Awards red carpet, and I have with me, from the film Sweetheart, director Cody Lepke and director Ken Cole. I couldn't think of your first name. I apologize. Director Ken Cole. And you're holding something, so you must have won.
Yep, I won Best Supporting Actor in a short film.
Okay.
And it's amazing. It was a surprise.
And what role were you in this short film?
I was the actor.
You were the actor. Hi, I'm the actor.
I'm the actor in the movie.
So I'm the director and the actor.
Yeah, director, so actor, and everything.
So the multi-talented team here we have. And how did you find the festival this year?
How did I find it? I just saw it on Facebook. I saw one of my friends was here last year, so I followed the festival, and then I just decided to submit this year.
Alright. And will we see you back here again next year?
We sure hope so.
Good. That's great. And so our talented team from Sweetheart, and we'll see you on the red carpet.
Thank you.
Hi, horror fans. We're here on the Fantastic Horror Film Festival red carpet. I'm here with the beautiful, multi-talented, and now multi-award-winning Lynn Lowry. If I asked you, do you think you could even name all the awards you went up and collected tonight?
No.
Okay. Let's talk about the one you're holding then.
Best Feature Film, Model Hunger.
Okay, so tell us about Model Hunger.
Model Hunger is about a woman who is rejected by the business early in her career. She becomes very bitter about it, and then starts killing young models who she resents. That's the map that eats them.
Thank you so much. Okay. I suppose that is one way to get rid of the competition.
Yeah,
right.
It is.
Now, I've got to tell you, there is a reason why her acting in this film was just fantastic. It was her job to make us feel that she was old and fat. Now, if you can look at this beautiful woman here on my left and tell me that that is anything to do with that, that tells you why she was an amazing and wonderful actress. Okay, so here we are with Lynn Lowry on the red carpet. Thank you, horror fans. We'll see you back here on the red carpet next time. Horror fans, welcome to the Fantastic Horror Film Festival red carpet. We're here after the awards ceremony, and I have with me
Krissa Silvers Nelson
with the film
Hans Krippelman Talking to Hans.
You're holding something, so that means you won something. What did you win?
We won the best comedy film.
Okay. Now, I saw that film, and I can tell everybody was laughing. This was hysterical. You're going to have to go see this film. Tell us a little bit about the movie.
It's about the ups and downs of a backwoods family. The main character, Hans, he is a haunted house attraction, and he entertains the crowd, and he is famous, and he has a fall from grace.
And then a redemption.
And a redemption.
Of course, gotta have a redemption.
And then we have the zombies everywhere.
Oh, okay, so zombies in Sounds good to me.
Yes.
We're coming at you from the. We're coming to you from the Fantastic Horror Film Festival red carpet. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hello, horror fans. We're coming to you from the Fantastic Horror Film Festival red carpet after the awards ceremony. And I have with me the beautiful and talented
Kristen West.
And Kristen West won an award at our awards ceremony, which was
Best Actress in a Short for Seeking Valentina, playing Valentina.
Okay, so tell us about Valentina.
Valentina is a person who comes to a home, Benjamin's home, and you can't tell if she's the ghost of Benjamin's dead wife, if she's a hallucination or a runaway. So she's very much subject to interpretation.
That film was one of the most beautifully shot films I think we had in there. And now tell me, girl to girl, okay, what's it like working with an actor that handsome?
I'll be very honest, Dreamboat. He is just gorgeous to look at. But what's more important about Ollie is he has, not only is he gorgeous on the outside, he's gorgeous on the inside. He has a wonderful attitude. He's dedicated to his craft. We really put him through his paces in the film, but he was there in every moment and present. And it was such a joy to work with such a wonderful scene partner like Ollie. He was just amazing.
Okay, now you were also in another film.
Yes, I was. I was in Strangers in a Book playing the very different character of Destiny. Destiny is very unlike Aunt Valentina. Valentina is very prim, very proper, very sweet. Destiny is none of those things.
I guess it all depends on what your destiny is, right?
Exactly. Destiny is kind of like your Trailer Trash nightmare comes alive. She's very, you know, Valentina is very, I was telling someone this earlier, Valentina is very head-centered and very heart-centered. Destiny is very stomach-centered and very lower body-centered.
Good way to put it. And we're here at the red carpet at the Fantastic Horror Film Festival. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you so much, Michaela. Love your website. Check out her website, horrorhouseparty.com.
Hi from the Fantastic Horror Film Festival red carpet after the awards ceremony. I am here with the handsome and talented Armin Nasseri. And he must have won something because he's holding one of those big plaques that I kept wanting to try to steal and take home, but I didn't get one. So, okay, so what did you win? What was it for? Tell me all about it. In 2 minutes or less. Okay. Okay, what okay, let's see. This is a memory contest. What concourse is Seeking Valentina?
Best Actress, Best Actress,
I'm hoping.
He wins the prize. Armin Nasseri right here from the red carpet at the Fantastic Horror Film Festival, and we'll see you back here on the red carpet. Hello, horror fans. We're at the Fantastic Horror Film Festival red carpet. The award ceremony is just over, and I've managed to corral two handsome gentlemen to escort me to the red carpet. And they're going to let me take home one of these plaques since I didn't get one. Why don't you introduce yourself to the audience and tell them what you're
doing? My name's Tommy DiBenedetto. I was the executive producer for the short film Once Upon a Time in the City.
I'm Scott W. Perry. I'm the director of the Harry Potter Once Upon a Time.
Okay, and I guess that makes me Kaylee Williams. I'm not Kaylee Williams. I'm the captain of our own Kaylee Williams Award. And I am just so glad to be here with you two gentlemen. It's quite an artistic film. What was it, your story?
It's really based on the story from Scott. So I will not hand over the details.
Yeah, it was a personal story about I many years ago I kind of hit rock bottom on a lot of things, and I really needed something to get myself back together, and out of it came this script, and that was about 9.5 years ago, and I knew I wanted to make it into a film, and I had several attempts to do it. This was pretty much the fourth try, and once I became business partners with Tony and another artist, friend of ours, Shay Cully, really gave it authenticity to the art world. We came pretty much set the ball rolling on and got it done. So it was very cathartic to see everything happen and be able to went through it. But it's really great to see that it's done, to see that an audience really appreciates and likes it. not now, I don't really feel that. No, it feels great. I know a lot of filmmakers came to me afterwards. They understood the story. So, you know, anybody who's an artist can understand that. Taylor Costello, Colton Pennington, Chris Ivers, great crew, the cinematographer, Stephen Mark Glassner, and of course Shay, if I don't mention her like four times, she'll get angry.
Okay, Shay. I think I got all four in, and that is it from the red carpet at the Fantastic Horror Film Festival, and we'll see you on the red carpet next time. Hello, horror fans. Here I am at the red carpet for the Fantastic Horror Film Festival. It's the awards ceremony night, and I have with me one of our nominees for the great short films, Spammer, a Cthulhu short film for all you Cthulhu fans out there. Let's hear it for those of us who love tentacles. So tell us about your film.
Spammer was basically an idea that John, my partner John, who's not here.
Oh, I guess I should say This is Song Sharati. He's the partner with John Iwas, who won last year's short film horror comedy film with Zombie Castle. Bunch of funny guys did another funny film.
Our idea was basically we decided one night after a lot of whiskey that, you know what, we hated spammers, people that send email and text messages and all that. We wanted to take one of them and take them out via HP Lovecraft. And that's what the film is.
And you did.
Yes, we did.
And you guys did a great job with it. That's it from the red carpet at the Fantastic Horror Film Festival. And we'll see you on the red carpet next time. Hello, horror fans. We're here on the red carpet at the Fantastic Horror Film Festival in San Diego. The award ceremony is just over, and I was able to corral one of our lovely and talented people with the film cut. That are going to swept a great number of the awards this festival. So,
my name is Christina Horgan, and I was the sound designer for
Okay, now, horror films and sound design, more than any other kind of film, let's face it, we listen to the sound. We want to hear when the knife hits, when the body hits the water, whatever. We're going to hear that. So tell us a little bit about how you went about doing the sound design.
Before the actual moment happens, you want to really build that fear into them, and they're ready for something, but they don't know what. I was real fortunate to be able to work very closely with David Roundtree, who directed and produced the movie, and he gave me an insight of what he was looking for, and it needed a lot of metal. And so I resorted to old traditional organic methods, and I pulled out every cast iron pan that I had, pots, utensils, farrier, tools from my dad's horseshoeing, rasps, just all, whatever, yeah. And my kitchen was off limits for about three weeks. And just started recording. I set up all my rig there and just started recording all kinds of things. Just, spatulas and pans, fried eggs without, water scraping, sizzling, butter, whatever you could think of. You would never believe, big stainless steel bowl and putting a little bit of water in it and then rubbing an old cheese grater around it, the sounds that you get out of it.
Okay, there you have it. You can try metal bowl, water, and an old cheese grater to become an excellent sound designer. That's all you need. Stay right there. Thank you for joining us on the red carpet. Next time we'll see you here at the Fantastic Horror Film Festival.
Yes.